Right, Mr. Fender, Doom came looking for the first win of the season here up against the USPS. Had a narrow win, well, two loss in our last game at Fairfield Fieldhouse against the Springfield Panthers. Your first league hammer, massacre of the Doom Stages, but right behind her is Devastator. Speeding up here, coming into this first straightaway. Master is small advantage here, Devastator pulling up. It's going to be a bang bang entry here. Master goes to the yellow line, pops it off quickly. Let's see what our points on that panel was. 3 for the Doom Stages, 0 for the USPS. The Doom Stages now to a 3-0 lead this month.
Indeed, first luck for the Daisies, but a lot of time, and it's not uncommon to have a 20-point lead evaporate in no time in this sport. Next frame features Morphine for the USPS and Rippin' Rooster out there for the Daisies.
Morphine from the box makes a 3-4 situation in favor of the US team. Favor of the Doom Stages right now. Rippin' Rooster trying to put the inside. Morphine on the outside of court. Scammer trying to push through. Now it's up for one Morphine! Lead Scammer for the USPS. Looking for the first point here. That Rippin' Rooster still stuck in the middle of the second straightaway. Now he gets out with plenty of time for Morphine to work here. Rippin' Rooster has an entire track to go. Morphine trying to find a way around Martinez, calls it off. And it's going to take 3 points back to the bench. That makes it a tie game here in game two. Both teams sitting on 3 points.
Right, you are all tied up. Next gym is going to feature Cam Jam for the Daisies, Flammable for the USPS. The pack's going to try to stagger in between the jam and the pivot lines.
And the box is now clear in both ranges within the play. Cam Jam hitting the wall, entered by Violent Assault, stations the back end. Four matches in the front, and Annabelle trying to find her way through a tough tripod of Doom Stages blockers. One skater off of the box by a USPS blocker that is solid, and now the power jam favors the USPS as Kane Jammer hit the box on her.
Yeah, power jam means that all the focus is on the one jammer remaining on the track, so that's Flammable. That means the USPS is trying to play offense for their jammer. The Doom Stages trying to play defense against her.
And only 30 seconds of penalty time left for the USPS to try and get them out of this. Cam Jam now standing in the box. Doom Stages less than 10 seconds left for penalty. Well, it's also into the box, and so is Cam Jam. So the Doom Stages do an excellent job of pulling the penalty on Cam Jam.
For those of you new to the sport, penalties, with one exception, are 30 seconds apiece. Just as we talk about the penalties, a penalty allows Flammable through. She is lead jammer.
Flammable under attack and is now scoring with Cam Jam. Close up on the initial pass. Flammable taking the card back to pack her deep smallest. Has to start over with Cam Jam now scoring to the pack. Flammable goes on the outside. Calls it off. Let's see what she got out of that one. All 4 points for the USPS on that one. So 4-0 jam on the power jam for the USPS. 7-3, favor of the USPS.
Assists on those points, she got a violent assault. She cleared out the outside part of the track, and all her jammer had to do was keep her skates rolling forward.
That's the one with discretion.
Joaquin Warrior lined up for the Doom Stages, opposed by Devastator for the United States Pummeling Service, going into the game 4.
Thus far, the USPS
Justice, I love it when the blockers get involved with the scoring process.
Yes, the jammers go through it. Yes, the jammers score the points. But those blockers, they grew, they implement the strategies. I'm a big fan of getting everybody on the track involved in scoring.
And apparently those are the ones who are
folks, don't forget to keep Rocky Mountain Roller Pods hanging out in the back by the merch table. They have a bake sale going on. You can get all kinds of sweet, tasty goods. We've got 18 minutes to go to half. Get you something to munch on and get you through the second half. A little bit of a feeling out process going on here in the first 12 or 13 minutes. With only 31 points scored, you know, at some point in time, Justice, things are going to open up. Those points are going to start to really tally up.
Yeah, that was really bad. It's slowly down here where we're scoring more than one pass.
Yeah, Cam Jam got forced off the track. And as per the rules of roller derby, you have to re-enter the track behind all the blockers. When that happened, Morphe was able to get out of the pack and around the track and actually was in a much better position to score, which is why the jam was called off without any points. Because Cam Jam had the lead, she could stop the action and play a little defense.
Exactly.
Megan My Day out of the pack as well, so both jammers are eligible for points. That's why Kiki Warrior engages the USB as in turn four. Gets bumped off by Extinction Lab Lament. Ellie making a count by 4 points on top for the skaters in blue and gold.
This is the 5-point game for USPS. 1-2 on the season for the 5-point lead over the Davis and over 3 on the season. This mark. This is our third place game for the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls 2017 season. Coming up next, the Red Riding person is sure to be one of the other four these season champions. Devastator Games for the USPS Massacre. For the two stations, Massacre gets back and bound after being knocked out of the infield. Starts over here, Devastator Games, but they need the time to move. Both players get a bump down. Massacre trying to find a way around.
Massacre has found some success.
into your battles. Pass it over the box. A 5-point pass for Massacre. It's a tie game.
Small pack is going to set up a turn three, mostly made up of daisies. That makes it easy for Massacre to slay that one. That's what we call it. And the roller derby. All 5 points going up top.
And USPS has a huge couple of troubles right now. Devastator out of her initial pass, Master calls it off, and the two stages are in the lead, 30-20, after a 15-0 down from Massacre.
Here comes that opening up process we talked about, Justice. Duke's Daisy just laid a big smackdown during that frame. Now it's up to the USPS to respond.
First time the Duke's have led since the first game of the game. And now they're registering the penalty. More seed for the USPS and the prisoner for the Duke's Daisies. Both the jammers trying to clear both teams out and the speed jammer for the USPS. ELE in front of the pack, trying to hold the line, whipping Mr. Morgan, trying to finish off her initial pass, her first scoring pass here. The Jimmy Bruce is still on the mission. Whipping Brewster once again not to be instilled by PLE and brought back 4 feet is true. With the grand slam now just a 5-1 game. PLE, Ellie is continuing her strong defense in the pack. Whipping Brewster is out before he has a chance to get through. One on one with Coyote. Knocked out of bounds under the fourth bench by Coyote. Let's see what the points were for USPS on that one.
Murphy wanted that final point at the end, but Coyote rejected the jammer the same way I was rejected for a date to prom. Fast, harshly, and without any remorse.
Murphy unable to get the last point on that, but does make it a 1-point game after that 9-0 run to the Blue Jays with a single solitary point lead. And jam versus Cordell on the Blue Jays at the USPS respectively. Cordell stuck in the back and now Cam Jam has to start over with both of them out, but has to pull back behind Sweeney Ramone and starts it all over again.
She works on that full head of steam now. She attacks the USPS again. Trips it down to Tula on the backstretch. Finds a seat in Cam Jam.
Devil's Hunter sits in the box as the blocker pulls through the daisies as Cam Jam comes in for her first point. Annabelle still trying to find a way out of her initial pass.
We've got a star pass, our first one of the night, in case you knew the roller derby. The skater with the stripe on their helmet, the pivot, can take the star cover from the jammer and become the jammer where they put that star on their helmet. That's what Sweet Ramone just did for USPS.
And a sweet apex out there for Sweet Ramone to get out. Cam Jam, though, happy to run the clock a little bit, calls it off with her 5-0 win. 35 Blue Jays and 29 USPS. Just over 10 minutes left in the first half.
Hey, folks, this portion on the mound is brought to you by Dr. Borman & Associates. For all your chiropractic needs, go to drborman.com or look around the facility. Mr. Borman is here tonight. It's not often that the chiropractor comes to you. Take advantage of that.
So we have some very short official time out there. Everything is squared away. So we're going to get back into action here in a moment. Devastator games for the USPS, opposed by Rocky Warrior for the Blue Jays.
Devastator finds it inside line, but does not stand well to the track cut.
Power Jam Blue Jays as Devastator is in the 37th box of Penny.
And one of these tightly contested match, Justice, it oftentimes comes down to penalties. More specifically, penalties on the jammers. If the Doomsdaces can take advantage of this like they did a few jams ago, this could be the difference maker in the battle.
Doomsdaces are going to speed 10 points so far. Right now, Six is walking the Warriors, trying to get through her first scoring match, which took over 5. But she will be able to break cleanly here. Violet Hayes off is anchoring the tripod in the front here. Wakiki Warrior gets the call to call in, but it is not before Jackson enters the box. So Doomsdaces pick up a 5-0, but are unable to extend the power jam situation. Now being Violet.
Yeah, a little bit further explanation of what we thought was going on is the Doomsdaces were trying to call up the jam while the USPS jammer is still in the penalty box. If you can do that, then you start a jam. With the power start, you're the only jammer on the track. Unfortunately, the Daisies were just a little too late. So now, Morphine is out there for the USPS, squaring off against Massacre.
Massacre and Morphine for the Daisies of the USPS, effectively. Massacre taken to the outside by Sweeter and North. Morphine is stuck in the back, trying to find a way back. Let's see what the USPS got. Looks like they were able to pull out 2 points. Now a 9-point game. Doomsdaces 40, USPS 31. Now 8 minutes left in the first half.
Continuing after the USPS as Cam Jam goes back to the penalty box. The good news is her seat is still from the bad news is the USPS can take full advantage. Devastator makes one more pass through, a 5-point tally, and a timeout call by the USPS.
USPS back in the lead after pulling for a few minutes, and that's 5 minutes left in the half. 10-point game.
This timeout is brought to you by 5-on-5 Magazine. Skater-owned and operated 5-on-5 Magazine is at the new section on officiating. To continue to be informed, improve your game, and keep up with the latest in five-track motorboarding, subscribe to 5-on-5 Magazine to receive beneficial information from all levels of skaters. Visit 5on5mag.com for more information. All righty, that whistle is the end of our timeout, so the next whistle will get us back to the action. With just under 5 minutes to go in the first half, the USPS riding high after that jam. It just concluded with an 8-point lead, but as we've seen the entire first half, Justice, things are going back and forth, and that 8-point lead is certainly not safe.
More people will have to come from the years, and then still sits in the box after going to the sits in the box late.
Going to be squirted off against Devastator.
So, Coyote exactly 1 year since ACL surgery. She was injured in last year's 2016 playoffs in Montreal. Exactly 1 year since I moved to the surgery. On the other side of the track, USPS Devastator has rejammer for her team. Coyote trying to find a way through. Now the star in hand. Devastator coming through for her first point. Not out of bounds and brought to the rear by Martinez. As Coyote moves out. And now Devastator moves on here. The finish off her pass, calls it off just in time, and is able to pick up all four. So we score 79 USPS 42 James Hazes. Now under 2 minutes left when this next game begins.
This next frame will feature 44 versus 34, Megan My Day versus Massacre. Friendly box is empty, so we are at 5-on-5 action.
Megan My Day to the USPS and Massacre to the James Hazes. Massacre to the other track and find a way around the LA.
Those jammers quickly bumped off on the inside part of the front stretch, but get back to her. Pat still constricting air down to turn one. Megan My Day finally backlogged, so a power opportunity for Massacre and the Daisies to try to get some momentum going their way, going into the locker room.
Yep, and the Daisies need this right now. Massacre did have a 15-year game earlier in the game. That's supposed to be the Daisies in front for a little while. But now, the USPS did a good job of killing this penalty with Ellie in the front now, anchoring this tripod. Gets around, comes around the outside, but not legally. She cut the track. Power generator splits to the USPS. Megan My Day will have 30 seconds of monopoly time here. It will likely be the last jammer to have.
It definitely will be the last jam, Justice, because we won't have a lead jammer. That means that that jam clock now at 45 seconds is going to continue to tick, and we're going to go the full duration into halftime.
And this is another power jam. Megan My Day went right after the box. Massacre now comes out, and she will have 33 seconds left in the period to try and pick up some points for the USPS. Massacre comes out of the outside, picked off by the pivot for the USPS, good by you. Start all over again.
This is one of those times where penalties are not 30 seconds. You have to always have a jammer on the track. So when you're swapping out penalties on the jammers like that, as soon as the second jammer gets penalized, the first jammer is released, and the second jammer serves the exact same amount of time.
We were going to be able to block her all the way back. Now more than just a spot, hold on, pick it up one more. We're dealing with Coyote, the Brooklyn Knights, and now forced back by Jiki Jiki again. She successfully gets her all the way back this time. Master's penalty comes to an end before more making it out. So the jammer status still open for both jammers. Working the star in hand is nailed on the outside by Martinez. And now Chi-Chi showing up and helping her as well. Chi-Chi maybe trying to keep her pack together. Working one-on-one with Martinez in front. Martinez all over the place. Finally has to let her go. The master had all the time in the world to finish off that pass. That's going to be a 4-0 run to start the Duke's baby pack.
That's the way you want to start things out. Chip away that lead because the USB has a huge momentum advantage going into halftime. You can't score all the points all at once, but you can nibble away at that and slowly take care of it.
Especially Keith Ward's hand being able to carry a full 30 seconds of jammer defense before Master got out of the box and cleanly finished that. Megan My Day What a big face.
Good night.
Dumping it outside of turn one as Megan My Day gets the last point as we enter for her first points of the half. You are just all out in the third year with Ellie and Zubai. Working over Cam Dan successfully. Zubai, you will have to continue to watch the mobile player block, but Cam Dan unable to exit the back.
Megan My Day recycled back to turn two behind the Kiki Dicky. That's where she's got to go to rejoin. And it's quickly met with a four ball.
Justice on the peach off the penalty box for the USPS, followed by Hayden Wallace for Duke, followed by Nellie for the USPS. As once again, the team shooting blockers in the penalty box. Megan My Day trying to find a way around Kiki Dicky. Now helped off by Graves. Drop the rear of the pass.
Turn one has to recycle back to that pivot line.
So Woo! first and second quarter pass. It's the back part and comes around through by you. 10 points for Camden. Still coming as Devastator comes out of Pennywise. And Morgan used to do Daisy Devlin right back to Pennybox. The power band continues. Cam Jam, 15 points so far, and now a chance for more. Hits your battle, hits the Pennybox on a top round clock. As Cam Jam stops trying to get through, calls it off. And will pick up a total of, waiting to see if there are more points on that pass. 4 points of 5 more points, 8-20 to zero jam on Cam Jam. And another power jam to start this frame to the Duke Stadium. 116-71, the Duke Stadium is trying to rally here in the last 17 minutes of our third place game.
They got things set up pretty well. Ripping Roosters got a power start. And there are only 3 lockers out there for each squad. That means there's a little bit more real estate for the Jammers to work with.
Power jam moving towards the door of the Rooster. But the quick lead jammer status for Ripping Rooster. Devastator out of the penalty box. Trying to start through as Ripping Rooster threatens the point. Tough break there for Ripping Rooster, trying to take back the cut. It wasn't in time, and now the power jam and it switches to the pivot turn jammer, shooting the button. It is through on a smooth 5-0 pass.
We just lost our lead jammer to the penalty justice, so we're going to save that full 2-minute jam. And Speedy Ramone is where the star for the USPS.
Denied by Coyote on the outside of turn 3, has to start over the USPS. Playing full passive here, allowing their jammer to go solo against these 3 blockers for the Duke Jazers. Going battle, Speedy Ramone trying to find some space here. But Kiki and Martinez out there, along with Coyote, successfully holding back 3. Ramone trying to switch the defense. Ripping Rooster runs around to the battles and picks up 4 on the run.
Cherry Mello with a good hit on the front stretch, but she was called for a forearm. So the quest continues to try to get Sweetie Ramone out of the back. She's going to have a power opportunity as Ripping Rooster goes to the box.
It's a low block if you're trying to get around the senior itself. So once again, the USPS will start this next jam on the power jam. As Ripping Rooster will end at the penalty box. Overall, a chaotic Ripping jam ends up going playing it to a believe four. We're waiting on for a control of that jam right there.
Sweetie Ramone looked exhausted at the end of that jam. Looked like she wanted to be sedated. To hang out the pen, but maybe in the events there try to get some air. Maybe my day though is gonna take that star with a good opportunity for the USPS.
A few more moments left there for Duke Stacy, so that was a 10-second run. Megan Bryan going with unopposed for a few seconds here against Ripping Rooster and Ripping Rooster. Coyote off the penalty box as the Duke Stadium pivots. Power jam completes as the USPS turns their attention to Ripping Rooster out of the penalty box. Meanwhile, David Van Dam is through 4-5 points. David Van Dam now coming around for a second scoring pass as Ripping Rooster unable to escape for additional. Ripping Rooster is able to escape a star in hand to get it back now, and now Megan Van Dam is going to take that score and the 9-0 run for the USPS, 135-278, with only 13 minutes and change left here in this third place game.
Timeout called on the track by the Duke Daisies. This timeout's brought to you by CrossFit Cali. With a state-of-the-art facility, CrossFit Cali offers a range of classes and training for CrossFit Masons to Olympic lifting, giving all women the opportunity to start, continue, or expand their fitness journey. Go to CrossFitCali.com for more information. That's CrossFit Cali with Cali, spelled K-A-L-I.
After this game, we have our Rocky Mountain Roller Girls Home Season Championship Bout. The undisputed Red Rhinos going up against the 2-1 Sugar Hill Gang. That game is coming up right after this one.
And we also have entertainment from the
Jackie Long tonight, Mr. Paul. Hang in my day, all the low ground, and how we get PSPS. Kids of people, not up in the top, up in the third two, after start losing to avoid the track back. And those are the hurdles of the other way to track back. And now, making my day off the Mindy Box Coyote Race.
So now Coyote will be set free. Make my day will show the exact same amount of time that Coyote did, whether that was 15 or 20 seconds. This is the one time where Mindy's not 30 seconds. We're going to go to all 2 minutes. Coyote on the back of Jack is now eligible for points on the back of his setup. It's turn two.
For a third place game, 10 times around Annabelle, 101 in turn 3. Meanwhile, Megan My Day is returning to the friendly box. Coyote is through Megan My Day and stuck in turn 4.
Coyote's driving 5, Max speeds up. Everybody's trying to help out or prevent Megan My Day from getting out of there, depending on which color you're wearing.
With 20 seconds left, Coyote coming in for a second score pass. Welcome to the back by Speedy Ramone. Megan My Day is out of her initial pass and now comes for her first one. Coyote able to finish off a second scoring pass. Time will expire on the jam before she can get around to get this. Megan My Day has the cue for the USPS.
Just under 7.5 ago, Buck beats second. 159-93 in favor of the red, white, and blue. We got Massacre and Ellie winning. They're on the way on the jam. Okay, 4-on-4 pack, so it's a 5-on-5 skating style.
Ellie and Massacre pop it over before you get into the game. Next to the other end, almost exactly 7 minutes left in the game. Ellie about to be outside by Ray Chirinello. I'm sorry, she is denied by the referee. 4-on-4 power jam to the stations.
Here comes Massacre. Give her an opportunity and she will take full advantage of it. Good opportunity as well for Daisies to make his statement in the last portion of this bout. Massacre gets a lot of help from the blockers, but gets bumped off at the last second by Flipper. Fantastic defensive work there. Massacre then has to recycle back all the way to 3 and 4. She calls it off. That's kind of like donating your used phone to an homeless community. It's just not worth it. Call it off, go do something else.
Yeah, I was teaching college, you mentioned that nice clear. Unfortunately, Massacre was unable to get all the way to Flipper 4 and give the rest of the power jam to Coyote. However, Ellie outstanding in the penalty box, but she has fewer than 10 seconds remaining on her punishment. Coyote is trying to compensate with here for the Daisies here to take the first place game. Up for grabs, but 4-on-3 to the penalty box. Ellie is going to come out of the penalty box. Power jam, USPS.
Ellie in a good battle to turn a little bit all the way up to finds a way around that. Then there's a 3-wall feeder at turn 2. All to do a good job reabsorbing with her defenders. A 2-wall, that is Waikiki Warrior and Maria Frey. Now it's a 1-wall, Waikiki Warrior and Ellie between turns 3 and 4. Ellie's we do not have a lead jammer, so once again, Justice, we're going to do another 2-minute marathon jam.
Good news and good news right here as the clock is done for Coyote. Distance through their first point pass by
track. What happened is the USPS wanted to take a look at something during that last shift. So each team has the ability to challenge or review something. That's what they're doing, and before the whistle starts is when they have to do that. This official review is brought to you by Skating. Whether it's t-shirts, hoodies, hats, or posters, Skating's got you covered. Skating has one-of-a-kind derby-themed items you won't find anyplace else. Go online to skate-inc.com to find more information.
So this is actually an official review for the USPS. They're looking for a touch on the Houston Daisies jammer in the previous match if they were to win it. It would be a full 30 seconds of power jam time for the USPS. If not, they will lose another year.
Right now, search for Team Korea. Pick up some Team Korea merchandise. Proceeds to help get all these skaters over to England in February for their rolling derby in the World Cup.
The Dune Skaters is calling a victory review looking for a contract call on Zoom Bayou to say that she struck Latina Warrior during the previous game. And if Dune Skaters win this one, they will have an hour to hand it from the game to the next one. If not, they will be down to 1 clock stoppage, but only 41 seconds remaining on the Dune Skaters.
And with only 41 seconds remaining in this bout, this is a good time for me to remind both squads to start thinking about your MVP votes. Who's been that jammer or blocker that's been a pain in your side for the last 60 minutes or so? Report your votes to me, and then shortly after this bout, we'll hand out some MVP awards.
Bring it.